Hello everyone and welcome to the teaching show. In this video, we are going to learn about mixture of ideal gases. So if you have two or more ideal gases denoted by, let's say, symbol A, B, C, these are different types of ideal gases. If you mix these ideal gases, the resulting mixture will also behave like an ideal gas. So let's consider this case where I am mixing Na moles of A, Nb moles of B, Nc moles of C and so on. And then and it is at pressure P and temperature T. Let's say that it occupies a volume V. Okay, so then because this mixture of ideal gases, it behaves like an ideal gas, so I can write down the ideal gas equation for this mixture as well. So I have written down PV is equal to nRT, where pressure is P, temperature is T, V is the volume occupied by the mixture, and N over here is the total number of moles of gas, and that is equal to Na plus Nb plus Nc plus and so on. Okay, so I can write ideal gas equation for a mixture of ideal gases. Now, let's consider a case in which I have only component A. Okay, so if I have only component A and then it occupies the same volume and it is present at the same temperature, then the pressure exerted by this gas A alone will be less than the total pressure which was exerted by the mixture. Okay, so let's denote that pressure by PA and let's call it partial pressure of gas A. So understand this point once again. Now over here only A is present, number of moles of A is Na as it was present in the mixture. No other gas is present along with A, and it is at temperature T and it occupies the same volume V. Then the pressure exerted by this component A alone is the partial pressure. Now since A is an ideal gas, for this situation also we can write ideal gas equation. So writing it down, we get PA into V is equal to NaRT. Okay, and this PA is your partial pressure of A, and from our knowledge of ideal gas, whatever we have read till now, we know that this pressure exerted, it will be less than the mixture pressure. Okay, so I have written down ideal gas equation for this case. I have written down the ideal gas equation for the mixture as well. Let's divide this equation by this equation. So that's what I have done over here. I'm dividing the second equation by this equation, first equation, and what do I get? I get V cancels, R and T, they are same, they cancel. So I am left with partial pressure of A upon total pressure of the mixture, that is equal to number of moles of A divided by the total number of moles in the mixture. Okay, but what is this Na by N? That moles of A divided by the total number of moles, that will be the mole fraction of component A in the mixture. So what we get is that partial pressure of A divided by the total pressure of the mixture, that is equal to your mole fraction of component A. Okay, I can rearrange this equation and I can write it as PA is equal to YA into P. Similarly, I can do the same thing for component B, component C. I can take them alone in the same volume at the same temperature and find out what is the partial pressure exerted by component B alone when it is present alone, component C when it is present alone, and I can come up with the same equations of partial pressure as PB is equal to YB into P, PC is equal to YC into P and so on. Okay. Now let's just add up all these equations for the partial pressure. Then what do I get? PA plus PB plus PC and so on, that should be equal to YA into P plus YB into P plus YC into P and so on. Since P is a constant, I can pull it out of the summation, and then what I am left with is only summation YI. You all know that summation YI, that is the summation of the mole fraction, it will always be equal to 1. So summation YI is 1, and the summation of all the partial pressures will be equal to the total pressure. This is known as your Dalton's law. Okay, so Dalton's law tells you that summation of all partial pressures, that is equal to your total pressure of the mixture. And one more thing which we get from here is that partial pressure upon total pressure of the mixture, that is equal to your mole fraction. So these two points are important. Just remember this, okay? Because we will be using it in our numericals when we go and solve numericals of material balance, which involve mixtures of ideal gases, then we will make use of these two facts. Okay, now let's move to another law, but in this case something is little different. What we are doing is that again I am taking A alone, so number of moles of A is Na. Now I am keeping this Na at the same pressure and temperature as was the mixture, okay? So this component A is now present at the same pressure and temperature as that of the mixture. Then in that case, in order to exert the same pressure, the volume will be different. I have component A alone at mixture pressure P and temperature T, and I can find out what will be the volume which is occupied by now this component A alone under these conditions. I will call that volume as pure component volume. Since A is again an ideal gas, so I can write down again ideal gas law for this. So P into VA, that is equal to NaRT. I can write down this equation. Okay, now let's do the same thing what we had done for Dalton's law. Let's divide this equation, third equation, by the first equation which I had written for mixture. So that's what I am doing over here. I have written this equation in terms of pure component volume VA, which is present at mixture pressure and temperature. Okay, so if I divide equation third by equation one, I get this equation. Now pressure is constant, so it will get cancelled. Temperature is same, R is constant, it gets cancelled. So what I am left with is that VA upon V, that is equal to Na upon N. But what is Na upon N? That is the mole fraction of A. And what is this VA upon V? That is the volume fraction of A. Okay, so that's why for ideal gases, every time when we say that, okay, if you have been given composition in mole volume percentages, then you can convert it into mole percentage, because volume fraction is equal to mass fraction for ideal gases. Mind it, for ideal gases only. Okay, now I can write this equation in a different form, that is VA is equal to YA into V. Again, like what we had done for Dalton's law, I can write this equation for component B, component C and so on. So that's what I'm doing. I'm writing this equation for other components as well. So it gives me VB is equal to YB into V, VC will be equal to YC into V and so on. If I write all those equations for I component and then I add them up, then what do I get? VA plus VB plus VC plus and so on, that should be equal to summation YI into V. Since V is the volume which is constant, okay, because to start with your mixture volume is constant, okay. So V is constant, I can pull it out of the summation sign. Summation YI, I know that is equal to 1. So addition of all pure component volumes, that will give me my mixture volume. This is nothing but your Amagat's law. Okay, so now you have seen how to derive your Dalton's law and how to derive your Amagat's law. And two things which you get from Dalton's law is that your partial pressure is equal to mole fraction multiplied by total pressure. Also, you find that summation of all partial pressure should be equal to your total pressure. Same over here, we have seen that my volume fraction will always be equal to my mole fraction for ideal gases. And further, we had seen that summation of all pure component volumes will be equal to my mixture volume. So these things we had seen over here. So now we will take a simple problem on ideal gas mixture. Let's say that I have an ideal gas mixture which contains 35% helium and 20% methane, and it also has 45% nitrogen, and all these are given by volume. Okay, and this mixture is present at a pressure of 2 atmosphere and a temperature of 90 degree centigrade. Okay, so first part, it is asked to calculate what are the partial pressures of these components. This problem I have taken from Felder, and it is an unsolved problem number 5.25. So this is 5.25 unsolved in Felder. The problem statement is given in the description box. You can check it over there. Okay, so first part says to find out what will be the partial pressures of these components. Now you have been given composition by volume percent. Okay, now just now we had seen while deriving Amagat's law that your volume fraction is equal to your mole fraction, or we can say my volume percent is equal to mole percent. So directly I have, let's say this is component A, this is component B, this is component C. Then I have YA is equal to 0.35, YB is equal to 0.2, and YC is equal to 0.45. If my total pressure P is 2 atmosphere, then I can find out PA is equal to 2 times 0.35, that is YA into P, that is equal to 0.7 atmosphere. My partial pressure of B, that is of methane, it is equal to 0.2 times 2, that is 0.4 atmosphere. And my partial pressure of C, that is equal to 0.45 times 2 atmosphere, that is equal to 0.9 atmosphere. So it's very simple. Quickly you have calculated what are the partial pressures of each component. Just as a check, add them up and make sure that it comes out to be 2 atmosphere. So 0.7 plus 0.4, 1.1 plus 0.9, so that is 2 atmosphere. So we have checked that our answer is correct. Okay, now part B asks you to calculate what is the mass fraction of methane. Okay, now we had done that earlier. When you have mole fraction and you want to convert it into mass fraction or vice versa, you have to choose a basis. So I am going to choose a basis, and that is I will say 100 moles of mixture. Okay, if I say 100 moles of mixture, let's write down this in a tabulated form. Species, that is helium, methane and nitrogen. Then let's write down for this basis 100 moles of mixture, I have mole fractions, so I can write down what will be the moles of each of these components. Okay, so 0.35 times 100, so 35 moles of helium, I have 20 moles of methane and 45 moles of nitrogen. Now I will write down what will be its molecular weight. So molecular weight of helium will be 4 grams per mole. Okay, similarly for methane it is 16 grams per mole, nitrogen it is 28 grams per mole. Okay, so now I can convert, because I have molecular weights, I can convert number of moles into masses. Okay, so my mass of helium will be 35 times 4, that is 140. Similarly, mass of methane will be 20 times 16, that is 320, and that of nitrogen will be 1260. So these are my masses of each individual component gas. In order to find out total mass, I will just add them up. Okay, so that comes out to be 1720 grams, 1720 grams. Okay, now it's very simple. Mass fraction you have to find out. Just divide the mass of component A by the total mass, component of B, B by the total mass, and component C by total mass. That will give you mass fraction. So it has been asked only for methane. So 320 by 1720, that gives me 0.186. You can fill in the table and find out the mass fraction of other two components. Okay, do that on your own. And okay, I will just write down one for you. This comes out to be 0.7326. okay, the remaining is 1 minus this minus this. Okay, So we have done second part also. It's very simple. It's just a revision. We have taken two more problems previously on how to convert your mole fractions to mass fractions. We have again done that. Now third part, it asks you to calculate what is the average molecular weight of the gas. So that also I think I have taught in lecture 1 or 2. Okay, so you can go back and check my lectures, the previous lectures. In that, I had told you average molecular weight that will be equal to, how will you do it? You will weigh it on the mole fraction. So I am just writing it. It will be summation of yi mole fraction and molecular weight of ith component. So if you do that, you get 0.35 times this is what, helium, so 4 plus 0.2 times methane, it is 16 plus 0.45 multiplied by nitrogen is 28 molecular weight. So I get the value of average molecular weight as 17.2. Okay, this is just a revision again. Now the last part we will do again, that is the part D, and it asks you to calculate what will be the density of this mixture. We all know the density of the mixture is Pm by RT, that we had seen in the last video. Okay, but I don't know what will be the value of of this gas constant in the units which are given over here. So don't panic, you can quickly calculate what will be the value of R. We know that PV is equal to nRT. Okay, let's apply this for the standard condition, and we will keep the units like that given in the problem. The only thing which you have to remember is that always convert your temperature which is given in centigrade to Kelvin before applying your ideal gas law. Okay, so 90 degree centigrade, that is equal to 363 Kelvin. I'm going to apply this formula, rho is equal to Pm by RT, but I don't know the value of R. So this R value I'm going to find out using conditions at STP. Okay, so I'm going to apply the formula PV is equal to nRT at my STP conditions. So I know that for 1 kmol of any ideal gas, the volume which it occupies is 22.4 meter cube. So I'm going to write, let's say, okay, so pressure is 1 atmosphere, fine, because standard condition pressure is 1 atmosphere, 1 into 22.4 meter cube, that is equal to 1 kilomole into R into 273. Okay, so my value of R is 22.4 divided by 273, and what are the units? Atmosphere, meter cube, divided by kilomole, and temperature is in Kelvin. Okay, if I do this, I get the value of R as R is 0.08205. Okay, so I didn't remember R value, but since I knew my STP conditions, I could go and calculate my R value using that in whatever units I am handling in my problem statement. Okay, now everything else is simple. Pressure I have to keep in atmosphere, 2. What is m? That is the molecular weight. Now I am talking about the density of the mixture, so I will use my average molecular weight, and average molecular weight we had calculated in part C, that was 17.2. R is 0.08205 times temperature. Temperature is what? It is 363 Kelvin. Just check, all the units will cancel out. The only thing which will be left is, okay, 17.2, this is your average molecular weight, and molecular weight, what's its unit? It is, I can say, grams per mole or kg per kilomole. So over here I am taking the unit as kg per kilomole, because here I have taken kilomole. Fine. So if I do this mathematics, I will get the answer as 1.15, and it will be in kg per meter cube. Okay, so this is my answer. It's very simple. I didn't remember R value. I'm not going to learn by heart all these values. If I solve a problem, what I will do is, I know standard conditions for the unit which I am handling. I will just put my STP conditions in those units and then find out the value of R. For this case, I found out my value of R in atmosphere meter cube per kilomole Kelvin, because density was asked in kg per meter cube. Okay, so once I put that value over here, then I directly get my density in kg per meter cube, which was required. So this solves the problem. I hope you understood the problem and how to apply all these equations. And if you like this video, please don't forget to like it and subscribe to my channel. Thanks for watching.